G'day guys, it's Dom here from Neighbourhood. Have you ever wanted to focus on a specific outcome of a workflow and measure its success? Well, setting up goals in workflows helps you accomplish just that. And today we're going to show you how. As a heads up, you'll need either a marketing, a service, or a sales hub at either the professional or the enterprise level in order to use this feature. If you're keen on more practical support within HubSpot, Neighbourhood offers a comprehensive, easy to follow course so you're making the most out of what you've got. Stay tuned for more info at the end of this video. If you want to take your learning offline though, we'll include a downloadable PDF in the description below. So the first thing we're going to do is head across into our workflows tool. What we're going to want to do is use a contact workflow for this one. This tool is only available in contact workflows. So if you're using something like a deal workflow or a company workflow or one of the other objects in HubSpot, it's not going to work. It's just for contacts who are moving through a contact workflow. So let's come in here. Let's create a new workflow and hit next. So once you've got your workflow, keep in mind that this is a tool that's most useful for workflows that are trying to achieve an objective, through multiple steps. So let's say if you want someone to submit a form, or you want someone to click a button or do something like that, and you're going to send them a couple of emails in a row, or you're going to send them an email and then set a task and follow them up with a call or something like that. Something where you're going to be trying to get them to do something multiple times, and there's an obvious outcome that you're trying to achieve. So what we'll do here to represent that. Is in this workflow, I'm going to add a couple of emails. Now let's say, for example, these emails are pushing towards getting someone to submit a form. I want them to submit a form of interest, or I want them to submit a form for whatever reason, really. And I'm going to try a couple of times to get them to do that. I'll send an email, I'll delay it, I'll wait a couple of days, and I'll send another email. And then maybe after that, I'd set a task and give them a call or something like that. But let's just leave it as the emails for now. Once you've done that, you've got those emails set up. The goals are up here in the top left corner, so you can see alerts, details, set goal. Set goal is the one we want. When you set a goal, it does a couple of important things. One is that it tracks when someone completes that goal, so you get some metrics, you get some data and some analytics on how well your workflow performs, how many people entered it, how many people achieved the goal while they were in it, etc. But more importantly, it pulls someone out when they achieve that goal. The reason that's important is because if we're sending a couple of emails here trying to achieve something specific and they do that thing earlier than we expect, then we don't want to keep sending them emails or keep bothering them trying to get them to do something they've already done. So we have two emails set up currently. If they're both trying to get someone to submit a form and the person submits the form after the first email, we want them to get pulled out of the automation so they don't get unnecessary emails after that. So I'm going to set up this goal here to be a form submission. Let's use test form just as an example here. Apply that filter, hit save, and now our goal is set up. You can see it's changed to say view or edit goal. Let's just give this a name, example workflow, and then review and publish it. So let's enroll a contact so you get a feel for what happens when someone does meet that goal. So let me just enroll here manually one of the contacts out of our system. So let's use Lorraine as an example and enroll them. It says here our contacts will be enrolled momentarily. We'll give that a quick refresh. And then let's assume that this is the form we're trying to get someone to complete. So I've pre-filled it here with Lorraine's details. I'm going to submit that one. Now that that's turned on, anyone who moves through that process and meets that goal will show up within the workflow as having completed it successfully. You'll be able to track stuff like that here in the goals tab. So ours is empty, obviously, just because we aren't able to push anyone through in our test account. But if you were to come here, you would see the people who've moved through and how many of them have completed that goal, be able to give you some pretty interesting metrics on the success and the validity of that workflow in doing the task you've set for it. It would also, as we mentioned, move those people through and then take them out as necessary and as needed as they complete that goal. And there you have it. You now know how to use a goal within a workflow. If you're wanting to make the most out of HubSpot, Neighbourhood offer a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, and CMS Hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are best serving your customers while developing efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this below. As well, if you've gained value from this video or are keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure that you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget, if you're after a PDF version of this for later or you're passing it on to a mate in need, we'll include a link in the description.